Do you know why your application is not performing? IntelliJ IDEA can help you find answers to these questions. Let's take a look at the support IntelliJ IDEA has for profiling your applications. IntelliJ IDEA integrates multiple profilers. In the Gupta area, click the Run icon to view the list of profilers you can execute your application with. On Linux and Mac OS, you can run and profile your applications with the Java Flight Recorder or Async profiler, that is allocation profiler or CPU profiler. On Windows, you can use the Java Flight Recorder. Apart from using the Gupta icon, you can start profiling your application by starting it from the menu bar. Go to menu Run, choose Profile, the application you want to start, and then the profiler. You can also use Find Action or Search Everywhere and type in profile. Choosing this option brings up the previous run window where you can choose the application to run and then the profiler. IntelliJ IDEA includes out-of-the-box support for the Async and the Java Flight Recorder profilers. You can also configure them by using settings. Use Command comma on Linux and Mac OS and Control Alt S on a Windows system to open the preferences dialog. Go to Build, Execution, Deployment and select Java Profiler. You can also type in Java Profiler to let IntelliJ IDEA find this setting for you. Before you start using the Async Profiler with a Linux machine, install the perf tool and adjust kernel options. On Mac OS, the Async Profiler works out of the box. I am using Java 14 for this project. Java Flight Recorder is built into the JVM and included on all JDK distributions starting from Java 11. It works on Oracle JDK builds starting from version 8 with its commercial features enabled. At the time of recording this screencast, work was in progress on merging Java Flight Recorder into OpenJDK 8 tree. Let's start profiling an application with the CPU profiler. The output window displays messages from the application and a message here stating that profiler is attached with a link to open. When I click this link, I get an option to stop profiling and show results. I can view the results later or now. You can view a range of data from your application: flame graphs, call tree, and method lists. In my application, I'm running multiple services and I can profile them all separately. Let me run and profile another service using the CPU profiler. If I miss clicking this link and click elsewhere in the window, it will disappear. To view the profile data, open the profiler window. Use the switcher tab by using Control Tab and select Profiler. You can stop profiling and show results. Let me profile another service by using Java Flight Recorder. In this case, apart from viewing data like flame graphs, call tree, and method list, you can also view the events tab. Let's see what metrics you get with a flame graph. Every rectangle in a flame graph represents a function name. Blue rectangles represent native calls, and yellow rectangles represent Java calls. A flame graph is not a time series. It doesn't show the sequence of calling of methods in an application. It shows which methods are calling other methods. This is how the method stacks are represented, for how long and where they are executed. This graph might suggest where the problems are and where to optimize. A flame graph is another way of stating, hey, this is what happened when we profiled your application and we grouped it. The blocks are relative. It represents a snapshot total time on your CPU. A flame graph will not disclose which tasks were performed or called before or after. It lets you find out the total CPU time that is being spent by your application. For example, if it spends a certain percentage of time on method A, that doesn't mean it takes a lot of time to execute. It could also mean that you're calling it many times. So you could either think of reducing the number of calls to this method or optimize it so it executes in less time. Call trees represent flame graphs in a textual form. They show how methods are called and the percentage of total CPU time used by them. Method lists show a list of methods that executed when you profiled your data. It also shows the sample count. When you profile your applications using Java Flight Recorder, you can also view an events tab. It shows data related to JVM like garbage collection, operating system events, and much more. You can also attach profiler to a process which is in execution, including IntelliJ IDEA. This essentially means that you don't need to restart your application to profile it. Select the option Attach Profiler to Process from the Run menu and then select from the list of processes that are executing. Application profiling can generate a lot of data. To quickly navigate to the metrics for a method you're looking for, you can search it in the call tree by using the search option. Just start typing in the method name and you will find the matching results. You can easily view callees and backtraces for methods in your profile data with a single click. The results are shown in a separate tab. The profile data can be stored in a file by IntelliJ IDEA and other utilities. You can export your profile data to a file by clicking this option. You can also import profiling results created by other utilities or by IntelliJ IDEA. It is interesting to note that even though you can't use an async profiler on a Windows system, you can view its profile data saved to a file. With the integrated profilers in IntelliJ IDEA, you can also right-click a method name and select Method Merged Callees. The results are shown in a separate tab. With out-of-the-box support for multiple profilers like Java Flight Recorder and Async Profiler, IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate makes it easy for you to profile your applications without leaving your IDE. Thanks for watching.